Hi friend, this is IT expert Neil and you are watching howisolve.com. In this video, I'll show you how you can transfer large files from your Android phone into your computer. I'll be using a USB data cable and you'll need a Windows PC with ADB tools installed. I've got a dedicated video guide on how you can do that, so you can check that out. Basically, you'll have to install Google platform tools and ADB USB drivers for your particular device. Apart from that, in your Android phone, you'll need to enable developer options as well as USB debugging. In this video, I'll share with you a tool which uses the ADB interface of the push and pull commands and provides a graphical user interface using which we can easily transfer files between your computer and your mobile. I usually use this tool because I record my videos in my mobile phone and I need to copy these huge video recordings from my mobile phone to the computer, and using the default USB data transfer that is available in Android, I find it's quite unreliable. Sometimes the copy speed is very slow and it sometimes also gets interrupted, so it's not that reliable. But using this method, using the ADB connection, you'll get a reliable high-speed data transfer from your phone to your computer and vice versa. So without wasting much time, let's get started. So on your Windows system, I'm assuming that you have already set up ADB on your phone and ADB has been installed on your computer. So if you have done it properly, you can open command prompt, and when you type ADB devices, you should see your mobile phone listed over here. In the list of devices, you should see this entry where this will be the serial number and it should show here device. If this is what you get, then we can now proceed to the next step, that is to installing the software for our file transfer using ADB. And the name of the software, we'll Google it, we'll open a web browser and its name is ADB Overlay. This tool is provided by an XDA developer and you can head over to this first result that is from the XDA developer forum. And this particular member has provided this tool and it's been updated quite frequently. You can see the latest updated version available at the time of the recording is in April 2022 and it requires .NET 6. If you have not installed .NET Framework 6, then you'll need to install that. You can get that from just type in Google .NET Framework 6.0. And over here you can head to the download section and you can see we'll need the .NET runtime environment over here. You can see this is mentioned, and in this you can install the 64-bit version for Windows over here. Just click this and it will download the installer and just proceed with the normal Windows installation, and that should complete the .NET framework installation. Once that is done, you can download this tool. This will download a zip file. I'll show you that zip file. So this particular zip file you should get, you simply have to extract it, and in that you'll find the exe file. In ADB overlay folder, you should find these two exe files. Depending on your configuration, if you are using 64-bit system, you can open the 64-bit version and this particular interface should pop up. You can see this is the interface of this ADB overlay software, and you can basically see on the right hand side you have got the mobile phone that is currently connected to the system. The entire directory structure is provided. On the left hand side is our computer. So basically you can explore your mobile phone. Like, we can go in the internal storage. Internal storage is called SD card in my phone. And you can see over here in this, you can open the cameras folder by going in DCIM and then in camera. So these are all the camera photos and videos present. So now let's suppose you want to copy this particular file, how to save long bean seed. This is my video file. I'm going to copy it to my computer. So in this, you can basically right click and copy and then go to the directory over here. So to get to that directory, I will simply go to the Explorer. Let's say I want to copy it in this particular folder. So to copy it in over here, you can simply click on the address bar, select the address, Control C, copy it, and then paste it over here by typing Control V and then hit enter. This will open up this folder on the left hand side of the panel. So now you can simply right click, select copy, and then over here, paste. Using this software, you can also access your app's internal storage if you have got root access to your phone. So to do that, assuming that your phone is rooted, you can click on Android over here and then go in Shell Tools and check these, use SUC and use legacy support and use VisiBox and mount file system as RW. My phone is not rooted, so all these are not getting checked, but if your phone is rooted, then this particular features will get enabled. Once that is enabled, you can go in root and then you can open the data folder over here. Since my phone is not rooted, it's not showing me the data for this particular folder. Basically, you can go into data folder where the app's internal storage is if your phone is rooted, and then you can copy the files from there to your phone's internal storage, then you can copy it into your computer. So it's basically a two-step process. I found this tool very useful. This tool provides a graphical user interface for using the commands of ADB push and ADB pull. If you don't like the command line interface, this tool is very good alternative and which gives the same reliability of ADB connection for your file transfers and also the blazing fast USB speed, which is not possible using the default Windows File Explorer. I hope, friends, you like this video. If yes, smack that like button, share this video with your friends and family, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, howisolve.com. We have planned lots of videos in the future, so hit that bell icon to get notified as soon as we release a new video. Thanks for watching, friends. This is Neil signing off. Bye-bye.